command you to obey him, because he is God and you are not. You see, the scriptures declare that we were born in sin. See, we're born enemies of God. We're careless about the things of God. And in reality, all we do is think about ourselves, what we can get at whatever cost. And most of the time in our lives, we're preoccupied with everything besides God himself. And the only way you'll be made right with God, the only way your guilty conscience, see, the conscience means with knowledge. You have a conscience. God has given each man a conscience. Because you're made in the image of God. You know right from wrong. You know it's wrong to lie. You know it's wrong to steal. You know it's wrong to take God's name in vain. You know it's wrong to talk bad about other people. You know this. Why? Because you're made in the image of God. You didn't evolve out of some pond scum. You're made in the image of God. And that is the truth and reality of the scriptures. And my motive tonight, it's not just to come out here and yell at you to make myself feel good about myself, but because I care about you and love you and want to preach the gospel to you in hopes that you'll get saved. What do I mean about salvation? This means that you'll be made right with God. You no longer be an enemy of God. You no longer be in hostility towards the God you know exists. See, the Bible says you know God exists. Because without God, we cannot make sense out of anything. You see, we need an ultimate standard. Because every time we open our mouths, we make truth claims, knowledge claims, objective truth. Every time we say something, we're speaking in absolute truth. Objective truth. And you can only get objective truth with an objective God. And the truth of God is this, that you cannot have an absolute without an absolute God. See, in an